I'm Anil Seth. I'm professor of cognitive and computational neuroscience at the University of Sussex in Brighton and in England. If we think about how science has transformed our understanding of nature and our place in it, we can see it as a series of successive transformations. We first learned that we're not at the center of the universe, and then we learned that we're related to all other creatures. And the next transformation, I think, will be about our understanding of consciousness. This too is part of nature and continuous with other species. And understanding the biological basis of consciousness will really help us understand how we are part of and not apart from nature. Because some people think that it's almost impossible to scientifically study consciousness because it does seem a big mystery. How is it that the 90 billion neurons in our brains, each with about 1,000 connections, it's a very complicated mechanism. It's still a mechanism. Some people find it almost inconceivable how any kind of mechanism could generate a conscious experience, the redness of red or the pain of a toothache again. And one thing I've learned is that studying consciousness is a really intrinsically multidisciplinary effort. You can't just be a neuroscientist, just be a philosopher, just be a psychiatrist. In my laboratory, we bring together scientists and philosophers from many different backgrounds. So we have psychiatrists, virtual reality engineers, mathematicians, working alongside psychologists and psychiatrists and neurologists, because we need to understand the brain in many different ways and at many different levels. But there are also some common themes. And one of the common themes that I think is really productive in understanding consciousness is the idea of the brain as a prediction engine. If we think about our experiences of the world, it's almost intuitive to think that what I experience now is some internal representation of the external world as it really is, that I perceive the world as it really is. But what we're learning is that this is not true, that from moment to moment, the brain is continually constructing its conscious experience of the world on the basis of sensory information, but also its expectations or beliefs about the way the world is. A nice way to think of this is that perception in the here and now is a kind of controlled hallucination, a neuronal fantasy that's weaved together every single moment and might be somewhat different for each of us depending on what we expect to be out there.